So Israel's biggest non-state defense contractor has reported a 10% rise in full-year earnings. Now, Elbit Systems is pushing into cybersecurity and airline safety to boost growth. Our Middle East editor, Elliott Gotkine, has more. Elliott.
Francine, yes, and I've got the CEO of Elbit Systems with me now. He is Bezhalel Butzi Machlis. Good to see you. Thanks for coming in to us. Yeah. First, full-year earnings up, but fourth-quarter earnings and sales down. Are you being hit by cuts to defense budgets? What's been the drag there?
No, I think that the yearly results are very good results. Our backlog grew, revenue grew, our profit is better. And the company is growing, although there are some budget cuts, but I believe that Elbit is well prepared to the new challenges in the defense market. We are focused in intelligence, in cyber, in homeland security, in avionics, and in unmanned systems. These are the needs of the way we see it. These are the future needs of the market, and I believe that we are focused, well focused, on these needs.
And I want to ask you about the homeland security area, because you recently won a high-profile contract to defend the U.S. borders, or defend the borders, for the borders, protecting the borders with Mexico. How did Elbit, which in the grand scheme of things is a relatively small company, how did you manage to beat out competition from major U.S. defense contractors?
We are very proud that our subsidiary in the U.S., Elbit System of America, have won this contract. This technology is available here in Israel. Across our borders. It's a combination of command control system, communication, electro-optics, and other type of technologies, which are all combined. It's already operational here in Israel. All this technology was shifted to the US and was adopted by Elbit System of America, and we are very proud that we were chosen for this very prestigious program.
Should we expect more contracts like that, more of the same?
Homeland security is a growth engine for Elbit. There are many opportunities ahead of us in many places, and it's a growth engine for us for sure.
Okay, I want to ask you about Ukraine. A lot of concern about what's been going on there with Russia and its desire to annex Crimea. Are we on the brink of a new kind of Cold War here? Are we like to see defense budgets ratcheting back up, which, without wanting to put it any more bluntly, would be good for business for you?
It's difficult to predict, but no doubt intelligence became to be a very important subject, and intelligence is actually what we are doing, and we see a lot of potential in intelligence activities in many places in Europe, but not only in Europe, and I believe that the company is focused on the right growth engine for the future.
I also want to ask you about airline safety. Obviously a lot of focus the last few days about the missing Malaysian airliner. You've got your Sea Music system, right, which zaps missiles if they're fired at passenger airlines with a laser. But what would you suggest would be needed to avoid an airline disappearing in the way that we've seen the Malaysian Airlines, Malaysian airline do?
There are many technologies which can be incorporated on top of commercial platforms. We have many technologies
such
which
as
can be relevant. Sea Music is one of them, which can protect airlines against mempeds. But that's not the only one. We have other technologies. All of them can be relevant. And we are trying to take some of the defense technologies which we have today and to adapt them for the commercial market as well.
And would there be any specific thing that would have prevented this airline disappearing like that?
I don't know the details of this activity, so I prefer not to enter into
it. All right, we'll leave it there. Butzi Machlis, CEO of Elbit Systems, thanks very much for joining us this morning. Francine, I will hand it back to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Elliott. Now let's